Hello and welcome back to my little video series about the mathematics of tennis. In the end of the first video, I asked the question, what is the probability of probability for player A of winning the match given the probability of winning the set. So given the probability of winning the set or one set. And in order to ask or to answer this question, we have to be clear about what is probability, what do we mean with probability, because if we just use probability in an everyday manner, we might miss a good definition and we couldn't calculate. So we have to be clear about how we define probability and what do we mean with that term. So at first we have to state that a game of tennis is an experiment from the point of view of probability theory with uncertain results. Or outcomes. We call the results of an experiment outcome. So we have an experiment and we have some outcomes. And of course, there are different outcomes, not just one, and we don't know when they will occur. So different outcomes, like, or results. So what are the different outcomes in our case? One would be A wins the set. And the other one would be A loses the set or B wins the set, which is the same. You cannot lose and win at the same time. And we will call the first one, we will call it success from the point of view of A. And the other outcome would be failure. So we have success and failure. And of course, these are different outcomes of the experiment. And we don't know beforehand if A wins the set or loses the set. Otherwise, it would be quite boring to watch tennis or other sports. So a big part of the excitement of watching sports is that you don't know who will win. I hope it's not the only reason, but in some sports it's really the main reason why people watch them. So here we will have a look at the set of all outcomes. The set of all outcomes is called omega, and of course in this case it's just success and failure from the point of view of A. Of course the success for player A is the failure for player B and the other way around, so failure for player A would be success for player B. And we also have another set, which is the set of all subsets of omega, sometimes written 2 to the omega. It's the empty set, because the empty set is in every set. It's success. It's failure. And it's omega. Omega is success and failure. The members of F are called events, so F is the set of events of omega, or for omega. For omega, and it's also a sigma algebra of the events of omega. And I will explain now what a sigma algebra is. We call F a sigma algebra for omega if F isn't empty. So it's not the empty set. If an event is an F, then the event omega set minus A is also an F. So it's the counter event. And if you have several events, A1, A2, A3, and so on, in F, then the union of them is also a member of F. And if these three are fulfilled, then F is a sigma algebra. And in the case of finitely many members, F is just a set of all subsets of omega if omega is a finite set. So it's kind of easy if we just have finitely many events or finitely many outcomes of an experiment. We can just derive F from omega this way. We just write all the subsets of omega, and then we have F. We call the pair omega and F a measurable space. Measurable space. And on a measurable space, we can introduce a measure. And in our case, we want to measure probabilities. So the probability function is a measure. And it goes from F to the interval from 0 to 1 in the real numbers. And it has so three things have to be fulfilled. P of A has to be at least 0 for all A in F. And the second thing is P of omega has to be 1, because in omega there are all outcomes that are possible. And all of these together, they have to give us the probability of 1, which means 100%. So everything is in omega, so P of omega is 1. And the third thing is, if we have, say, A1, A2, and so on in F, so a lot of different events with aj and ak don't intersect. So the intersection of two of them should be the empty set. So for j isn't k, then the probability of the union of the AI should be the sum of the probabilities of the events. So for example, we will do the example, but if we have two events like success and failure, and you know you don't have success if you fail, then they both add up to the sum of both, so the probability of failure plus the probability of success will give us the probability of the union of success and failure. And we will see this in the example of this tennis match, how this works out. But this is called probability, and P is called probability. And omega F and P together, those three are a probability space. So let's go back to the tennis match after all this theory. We have to fill these definitions with life. So what is the empty set? The empty set stands for everything that isn't an outcome of the experiment, or that doesn't occur, for example, a draw doesn't occur, or that there's no result doesn't occur. There are two results that occur, and these are failure and success. And the empty set stands for everything that isn't possible, so it's called the impossible event. And what is omega set minus the impossible event? Of course, this is omega, and it's also an event, and it's called the certain event because it is certain that one of the outcomes in omega will happen. So success will happen or failure will happen. And of course, sigma algebra will always include the empty set and omega. And so what are the other events? Success, of course. Success and failure as I said are distinct events, and moreover, failure is the same as omega set minus success. So this is really important. And now we can introduce a probability function for this measurable space omega f in our case with success and failure of winning a set. But this will happen in the next part of the video.